Hey everyone, welcome to this video on this Balloons TD6 map. It's one of the first maps in the game. No, I'm just playing with you. This is a video on zombies. As you can see, this here is a video on a pretty good, it's a really good map. I'll get into the map, but for what I'd say in the beginning of it, it's pretty great. I activated that thing by accident. That's like rage mode or whatever it is. Don't do that. It's not easy. But yeah, so this is a Balloons. If you don't know what that game is, it's like the tower defense game where you bunkies and you throw darts and pop balloons. This is one of those maps. So it's fully custom with, obviously, as you can see, the balloon weapons. So like the dart monkeys, the boomerangs, the catapults when you upgrade the darts and all that. The perks are bananas. Oh, and also I'm a monkey. So that's pretty fun. The perks are bananas, and there are four perks, isn't it? The quick revive, jog, speed, water's wine, stamina, five perks. There's an Easter egg in the map that I didn't do, because there's no achievement. And the upgrade system is pretty cool as well, with the weapons. Hang on. Alright, so that may be a bit of a weird cut, but it was weird just sitting here in silence talking over this gameplay because I want to actually listen to it. So, yeah, here's the boomerang. It does actually boomerang. Well, it doesn't really. It goes straight out and straight back. It's like the Hell's Redeemer and Retriever in Call of the Dead, which is pretty fun. These weapons, so like, there's no pack-a-punch, but you can keep buying the weapon over and over again, and eventually that gets it to its highest level. Which is a really cool, I really like that feature, like, that's a really cool thing. I've never seen anyone do that in the modern map before. Like, imagine instead of having a pack-a-punch, you just keep buying the same weapon. So instead of buying, that's the only downside, you can't buy ammo. But, imagine instead of buying ammo, you just buy the weapon over and over again, and that upgrades it. Like a pack-a-punch. Like in Black Ops 4, with a stupid 4 pack-a-punch requirement to get it to its highest level. Like that. But, fun. Because I don't like Black Ops 4 Zombies. Anyway, moving on. So basically, you gotta buy it. It is quite expensive though, which is fair enough, I guess, because there's a lot of zombies. I mean, there's a lot of like open areas that you can train in, so that's fine, I guess. And then here's this, like, I didn't know what that was. I had no idea what that was, so I will just keep it a secret. And then there's the tack shooter, which is in Balloons. I was gonna say Plants vs. Zombies. It's in Balloons, and it does what it does in that game, so, yeah. And here's some, like, ninja star. Oh, actually, I forgot Mule Kick. Mule Kick's in the game as well, so we've got... No, Stamina is in it. Speed Coal is not in it. So there are... Four... I've lost count. Hang on, I'm kind of dumb. Quite Revive, Jug, Stamina Up, Mule Kick. Yeah, four. Okay. I was right. I don't know why I thought Speed Coal was in it, because it's not needed. Because you don't reload. And then here's like the sniper thing. It kind of reminded me of the VSR 11 in Call of the Dead for some reason. Did I say Call of the Dead or Mob of the Dead, by the way, for Hell's Redeemer? I meant to say Mob of the Dead. I feel like I said Call. But yeah, so right now what I'm working up to is those weird totem things. If you get a fully upgraded weapon, you can sacrifice it. Well, not really, because you can just go pick it back up for free. But if you get a fully upgraded weapon and place it into those totems, it then, like all three of them, they then consume zombie souls, and once you've filled them up with zombie souls, it unlocks... What does it unlock? I don't even know, actually. Yeah, I don't remember what it unlocks. Let's find out together. It does something. Like, as you can see here, it's like sucking up souls. Oh, yeah. It unlocks that main area up there, and that's where the... equipment weapon is. Like, you know how you press LB and RB and you get the equipment out? It's that weapon. It's like, it's kind of like the BFG, actually. But it's not. Here's me, jumping down. Look, I mean, honestly, I don't think I should have gone down there. I think I got hit, like, twice, and then the game just decided, ha, you're down. But, whatever. That was, like, my third down. I was not doing well. Oh, well, no, actually, towards, like... Once I got set up, yeah, it's the Apex Plasma Master. Well, it's the BFG. And there's Widow's Wine. I did not want it in the slightest. Yeah, I went down like 3 times. Once you get set up with good weapons, it's pretty simple, straightforward, easy. But in the beginning, I was kind of getting slapped about. So yeah, that Apex Plasma thingy unlocks that, like removes the ice from that big thing in the center. And I don't have a clue what it was. I thought it was like a nuke or something. But no, it's just the end game. So yeah, and it's free, which is really weird because when have you ever played a custom map with a free ending? And then there's me getting like this super, super amazing OP weapon, the Sun Avatar. Oh yeah, shit, actually I meant to say, when you put 3 weapons, like 3 fully upgraded weapons into the totems, it makes that available so you can shoot the monkey, the super monkey, and then it falls down, and then you can buy the super, super weapon. So yeah, there's that. And then you gotta keep upgrading it. It's expensive, but it's worth it for all of them. The thing I didn't really care for much, honestly, like, all the weapons do well, but they're weird. Like, look at this. So I'm just like, right, I'll just end the game then. And that's the end. I think we're dead. Also, I'm pretty sure the monkey sounds there were the monkeys from Shangri-La. Oh, another thing that I want to add on. There's a slight chance that there's more that the developer of this mod put into the game, but I also had another mod running that switches out the UI and the zombies and the weapons. It didn't obviously switch out the weapons here, but it's a weaponry overhaul, I think it's called, the mod. It basically just makes everything look nicer and act nicer, and but it's based off of Black Ops 2. So it puts the Black Ops 2 zombies in here, so that might have altered things a bit. But yeah, great mod, fun. An alright map. I would say it could be bigger and have more weapons, but yeah, that's all I could really say that could be done different about it. Otherwise, it's a really, really well-made map. So thanks for watching this video. This is the first zombies video I've done in a long time. Been playing Dark Souls a lot. And Elden Ring. But, yeah, anyway. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the channel. It actually does help. Leave a comment down below, because I think that also promotes the videos out in the algorithm. And I'll see you peeps in the next video. Goodbye.